Hi, welcome to Meal Deal Guide. Today what I'd like to talk about is a recent study that was published in JAMA, the Journal of American Medical Association, talking about unusual fractures related to bisphosphonate use. And so as a person with osteoporosis or low bone density, if you're on a bisphosphonate, you might be, you know, a little bit concerned about this study. So I thought I'd bring up a couple of points. First of all, I'd like to take you into the anatomy of where these fractures are occurring. Okay. We're going to zoom right in to the bones of the lower leg, specifically the thigh bone. The thigh bone is also referred to as the femur. In individuals that have osteoporosis, most fractures, most typical fractures that occur, in thousands and thousands unfortunately occur a year, most of them occur in either the neck of the femur, which is this region here, or what's called the intertrochanteric area, which is between the two trochanters that you see this region right there. And so those are typical fractures that we see people get, you know, admitted to hospitals all the time because of this very severe fracture. Now that's a typical osteoporotic fracture, and that occurs in that part of the femur because that's the part of the femur that has more trabecular bone, the higher proportion of trabecular bone. What the study showed when they, you know, looked at over 700 women who had actually had these unusual fractures, were actually in the region of the femur below the intertrochanteric area, or also referred to as the shaft of the femur. Now, what's concerning is that the shaft of the femur has a lot more cortical bone, which is usually known as really good hard bone. And so obviously people that are on bisphosphonates for over 5 years, the bisphosphonates having an effect not just on the trabecular bone, but also on the cortical bone. So what should you do with that information? One thing is that if you're at all concerned, you should definitely talk to your doctor before you discontinue your medication. If you are already at a high fracture risk and you haven't been taking a bisphosphonate for 5 years, chances are you might be recommended to continue your bisphosphonate. If you are at a moderate fracture risk or a low moderate fracture risk, you should definitely have a discussion with your doctor as to whether or not the bisphosphonate is the best approach for you. Whether you're at a low, moderate, or high fracture risk, obviously I'm coming from the arena of exercise is the best prescription, and we know that it helps build quality of bone, but you know, exercise is going to help you recover from a fracture as well. So you really should consider starting an exercise program regardless of your fracture risk. And so I hope that this allows you to have a little more clarity on the study and on the fracture sites, and thank you for tuning in.